This is not a test. This is your emergency broadcast system announcing the commencement of the annual purge sanctioned by the U.S. government. Weapons of Class 4 and lower have been authorized for use during the purge. All other weapons are restricted. Government officials of ranking 10 have been granted immunity from the purge and shall not be harmed. Commencing at the siren, any and all crime, including murder, will be legal for 12 continuous hours. Blessed be our new founding fathers and America, a nation reborn. May God be with you all.
Juice.
It's showtime.
Jody, now he's after me.
snag that tall dude.
The funeral is about to begin.
You have a vacancy.
12 cabins, 12 vacancies.
Norman!
That must be my mother. She isn't quite herself today.
I will not hide in the fruit cellar. You think I'm fruity, huh?
She just goes a little mad sometimes. We all go a little mad sometimes. Find any boy.
Then he's still there. Jason was my son, and today is his birthday.
Okay, kids, time for bed. Come on, I'll tuck you in a little bit. Oh, hi. Welcome. You're just in time for the party. Would you like a cheese puff?
Hello. I'm sorry to bother you, but I'm having a dinner party and I seem to run out of coffee.
You can be anything you want to be there.
You can see anything you want to see there.
There's excitement in the air for you and me there. Fancy free there, take your family there, but you've got to be there.
Yeah.
You just got to be there. What you want to see? Seven holes, the key there, be there. Got to be there.
Just got to be there.
Just you and me there.
Just got to be there.
Just got to be there.
Be there.
Be there.
Be there. The time is now. Be there.
You've got to be there.
Yeah.
You just got to be there. You'll feel free. Be what you want to be.
Hello, customers. It's nearly 6 o'clock. Pack up and piss off.
Ah, good evening, everybody.
Good evening. Welcome to your Wednesday night slice of campery.
Your pint of perfection.
I can't think of another. Your, what's a, flagon? Flagoon? What's that word?
Flagon of fun.
I can't think.
A bottle of burlesque.
Good evening. Welcome to the Wig and Slingback. From me, Jamie Honeyborn.
And me, Alain Guimont. Or backwards, Nobbing Nala.
And down there somewhere. Oh, she's out of camera shot, but she's actually underneath the camera.
She's grooming a little claw. You know, the side claw.
Let's have a look. Now, there's lots of you nattering away before the doors were even open.
Which is a good thing.
So, first through the door was, of course, Mistress Darcy, who is our bouncer, as you know. So, I'm going to move that around so people can see you a little bit more. There we are. So, Mr. Darcy through the door straight away. Then Angela Larson over from California, yay. Then Lee Ludlow.
Ludlow and Bloody Cahoon.
From Belfast, who are coming over this weekend.
As is Mr. Darcy.
So, yeah, all look out for an email in your boxes. We'll be popping something through your flap to say where we're going to be on Saturday night. So we'll see you there. Who else in? Bloody Stuart Cahoon chiming in as well.
They're gobbing off of Lottenot, Cahoon and Ludlow.
With Darcy. Right, then, let's see who came in. The Duchess flounced in, as did Darren Bramley, who has just sent me a little advert, or not sent me, he's put it on his Facebook, of Gloria Honeyford telling the crew from Loose Women to get up and dance, especially Darren. And she says, come on, Darren, join in. And Darren does a little... A little like Grease Lightning.
Darren will dance.
Hand jive. Paul Esselmont. Hello, Paul Esselmont. Hello to Gary Brooks, the crew. Now, Gary Brooks, the crew. I can't remember that name. But you're saying hi, boys, again.
So it's been in before. Have you changed your name, Dolls?
Gary Brooks, the crew.
Mm-hmm.
Who are you? Who are you? What's that from? Who are you? Maybe it's just a Scouse thing. Coral Daft is in. Coral Daft is cheering us with her jam shed. So we shall cheer you back with our lagers today, beers tonight. And we'll be seeing Coral this weekend as well.
Paul.
Joel Hazeldine is in. Who's leaving? Who? Is it me? Is it you? Won't you tell me, Joel Hazeldine?
Could you sing that with the words Loose Sweet Corn?
No, but I was going to say, I was going to call Joel Hazeldine something, wasn't I?
Hazeldine?
No, something new. And I said, oh, shall I start calling Joel that? And then you said, you'll have to ask him. And I've forgotten. It was cute, Joel. Who else? Andrew Chapman's in. Andrew Chapman is not in. Sorry, Andrew Chapman's working. So, screw off.
Oh, at least he pops in and says hello. Leave him alone.
I'm only teasing. Who else? Nubs is in.
Nubs? Yeah, Nubs.
That is Nibbles and Bubbles. Nubs, Jason Darcy's christened them Nubs, and I'm liking it. It's sticking. It's like Jedward and Brangelina, Nubs. Dale Ibbotson is in. Lovely Dale, we will be seeing on Sunday, I think, so we're looking forward to that. At the Bingo. Also seeing us on Sunday at the Bingo is friend of Carl Kennedy, Helen, aka Dinner Lady / Radio DJ. So we'll see you, Helen, on Sunday.
See you again.
Fancy dress, everyone. I'm looking forward to seeing what you're all dressed as. Dale should outdo everyone, shouldn't he?
Well, Dale's got costumes?
He's got an attic full of costumes. Lee Ludlow says Stuart and I are going to the Bingo, so we'll see you. Seven Network is in. Hello, Seven Network. We will be seeing you on Saturday night as well. Raymond C. Howard is in. Hello, Raymond. Howard. What were we saying all Howard at recently?
Oh, Miss Howard on the ghost thing.
Oh. Uncanny. Is anyone watching Uncanny? There's a podcast of Uncanny, which we've not listened to, but we've started watching it on telly, and Alan's going to listen to the podcast, aren't you?
Because I like stuff like that.
I'm not, because it'll make me scared.
Obviously because of Divinity.
Who else? Cilla Black is in. Cilla Black OBE. Hello, my darling. Welcome. A little cheeky Cilla.
Do you want to look at this?
Yeah. There she is. Nice to see you, Cilla. Cilla has risen. I'm just looking through names.
Looking for fresh.
David Moore. Hello, David names. Moore. Hola from Porto to Gareth. Marcia Maudsley and Ewan. Hello, Ewan. It's still your birthday week, so have a quick.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
Stairs. Have you seen that one?
Yeah. I had to cut it short so we don't get.
Stair choreography.
So we don't get pulled off. Stairography. Who else is in? Jeffrey Yanarek is in. Hello, everyone. Greetings from the United States. Mm. I've pronounced your name wrong, most probably. But Jeffrey, hello. Michael Redfern is in. Yoo-hoo, he says. Josh Sadler is here. How are we all? Padam, padam. Padam straight back at you, my friend. Lily Law is in. Hello, Lily. We'll be seeing you this weekend. Linda Lee Hughes is in the house. My cousin Lucy. Big love to you. Linda's busy losing bags of weight and not drinking as much. So she's on the odd gin and slimline, but that's it.
Well, they say if you're losing weight, the best drinks to have are clear ones, aren't they?
She's as healthy as can be. Is that
like vodka and gin with
Get yourself up to Scarborough and we'll corrupt you again.
We'll fill you with gin.
Who else? Who else? My dad's in, David Maudsley, which means my mum is in. Anne Maudsley, hello to you both.
They're talking about the cheese puff, aren't they?
Yeah, there's lots to talk about the cheese puff.
BG Bear?
BG Bear is in. BG Bear is in. We'll be seeing you this weekend. Oh, hang on. Although I don't, won't be here Sunday. I'm in Scarbados. Yay!
Ooh.
I read it differently than BG. Who else? Who else?
Josh Sadler, is it to him?
I've said hello. We've said padam to Josh. It's just all scrolled past as it does. So let's have a look at anyone I've missed. Raymond C. Howard is from Ayrshire in Scotland.
Scotland.
Emotional Homestead is here. Hello, Caroline. We'll see you at the weekend. Anyone else? Darren Small from Brizzle. Hello, Darren.
No capitals yet.
Diangela is in. Hello, Diangela. Oh, Diangela's in. I don't know if I've missed Paul's capitals then. Hugh Bonnet is here. Hello, Hugh Bonnet. Gary Brooks, the crew, hasn't revealed who he is yet.
Darren Small says Uncanny was ever so spooky.
Oh, it was. I don't know. I've missed out. I'm not sure.
I don't think there's new names.
Shalom to Pip. Pip has arrived.
Oh, Pip's
tad late, but always welcome. Shalom. I don't think I've got an anniversary song, but it is Nibbles and Bubbles anniversary today. I think it's 10 years. So especially for you, you can have a little snatch of... That's all you're getting. A little bit of Sue Pollard. Ross Morgan. Ross Morgan's here. Ross Morgan says, you missed me. Hello, Ross. It is anyone's birthday, so you can pop in a clip of happy birthday from Scylla. She's always ready to pop in happy birthday. Let's have a look over this side of the room.
First in was Joel William Hazeldine, our little chum from Windsor. Followed by lovely Sandwells. Neil, Lady V, and little Lord Henry.
Dr. Henry, Medicine Woman.
Followed by the lovely Sarah Simpson.
The Simpsons.
And she says hello and hope we're all well, including Peggy. Lovely Mark Hall says good evening all, little Welsh boys.
Yakita.
Jay Shaw, hello darlings. Tushy Washy Rushy from Hull, hello darlings. Ribbons Bobbin Stuffer. They're just sunning themselves in Tangier,
Daddy went and got shot in Dhaka.
Sending me pictures of camels and their toes on the beach.
So that's Ribbons, Bobbin Stoffer and Felipe Yaki Brotiafortes.
So they're having a lovely time, enjoying the sun. Followed by the lovely Alex, who's just getting chips.
We used to do a little thing where we cried about getting chips, didn't we?
He went to get chips, but he never came back.
I don't know what it was in
our friend Rod.
We used to do it all the time.
The Chippy Chips from the Chippy. Lovely Chris Gilbert and Chris, Wes and Rex the Whippet from Kingscliff.
Bethan Williams.
Bethan Williams, who's from Wales.
G'day, Bethan.
And we've got Gabrielle Chassay. Hello, darlings.
Gabby Chasse's got a spooky little profile pic at the moment.
He's silly. He puts some lovely pictures on Facebook, he does.
Let's have a look.
Gemma Alexander, hello, darlings.
She says, greetings from the other side of Aldi.
Yeah.
Bethan's asking, Alan, have you got new glasses on?
Well, they're not new, but they're part of my collection.
We're a bit like Sue Pollard with all our specs. Nubs is in. Christopher Prinder is here. Sorry for lateness of my arrival. My laptop's playing up.
Oh, so they're on the telly and...
On telly, on mobiles, on laptops.
Oh, they have spoilers, don't they?
There's a name there that I've not seen before.
Somebody says screw off, love it. Katie Marsh Davies in a pink hue.
Here we go. Joel Hazeldine's got a little question for us. When you were singing, Jamie, was it Who's Leaving Who? Is it Joel, the bracket guy? Who's Leaving Who is a Hazeldine song. There's a singer called Hazeldine, Joel, back in the Stock Aitken Waterman 80s.
Where were we?
Jay Loney from Bloody Jib.
Bloody, get yourself to Bloody Jib.
Get over to Jib and get yourself some cheap cigs.
Get yourself into Marks and Spencer's and give those little monkeys a little tickle.
I love Jib. It's like Spain, but England.
Saw it in Brandy earlier.
Ribbons Bobbin Suffers looking for Jib from Tangier.
Well, they're practically neighbours, aren't they?
I think that's everyone. Now, Gary Brooks, the crew, has said, just so Gary Brooks is, of course, oh no, Gary Brooks. I was thinking of, ooh, Gary Davis.
On the radio.
Because Gary Brooks' profile picture is Bruno Brooks.
Okay.
But we don't know who you are.
Oh, we've got another addition. Nick Van Grudgings.
Now, Nick Van Grudgings is my cabin crew chum.
Oh, is he?
Who, whenever I fly BA, I always send him a little cheeky message and say,
to
Nick,
see what he can do for you.
I'm popping into the McConomy cabin. See if you can get me through any curtainage.
Any free prep spores?
He comes and sometimes throws a little bag of those dry pretzels towards me. I was on Aer Lingus just 2 weeks ago, wasn't I? And I asked, you don't get free booze on Aer Lingus. You just get soft drinks. So I said, well, I'll get a Coca-Cola. One of those tiny little cans of Coke that, you know, the mixer ones. Mm. So I said, is that all I'm getting? They said, yeah. I said, well, I'll get three of those, please. And they didn't. They weren't best pleased, but I got three.
Well, they don't touch anything, do they, little ones?
No. And I wanted it with my meal. And then when you get your meal, you didn't get any drink.
No drink with your dinner?
No, you get a little plastic cup of water with a lid.
Oh, what's it turning into?
Ian Tushy Rushworth says, I've been meaning to ask you, Alan, what years were you at Greatfield High?
Oh, now, let me think.
Well, tell Ian Tushy Rushworth what year you were born. Because you're not ashamed.
72 I was born. I was at Greatfield, 85 to 88.
Only 3 years.
Is that
years?
Right?
Yeah, most probably. Because I did my GCSEs 2 years later than you in 1990.
And then I went to Wilberforce Sixth Form College from 88 to 91. Because I had to do some resits in my first year before I could do A-levels. I loved it. I loved it, Wilberforce. It was amazing.
Ribbons, Bobbins, Duffers, they're in Morocco. They were offered a massage today with a happy ending at Sophia's Spa.
Oh.
It says they're barking up the wrong tree.
Exactly. You wanted, like, what's an Egyptian man's name?
You wanted, I don't know. I can't think of one.
Christos.
When I had a massage, the woman said, do you want to wank? And I said, well, maybe.
What massage?
Maybe. She came back 10 minutes later and said, have you finished?
Is that a joke?
It's a joke. No, when I was in Kuala Lumpur, though, I was waiting at the train station. I was going to Batu Caves to see a large gold Buddhist temple. Mm. And I tried to get on the Wi-Fi at the station, and my mobile phone connected me to Slippery Fist Massage Parlour Wi-Fi.
Handy connection? I've seen the Turkish ones. I've seen them on telly. Where you're like thrown on a marble slab.
I'd like that sort of massage.
And they put their feet on between your shoulder blades and pull on your arms.
I'd love a really good massage. I like when I have a massage, I like to feel a little bit ill that night because they've really like
released
some
chemicals.
Yeah, some stuff. Right, my lovelies, let's have a look because I've got a question of the week, which is quite a fun thing to do.
Even I don't know it.
Now, this one is not from Sarah Cox this week, but it is from Twitter, and I saw it and it amused me. So, question of the week.
Can't read it because the camera's in the
way. What daytime TV shows of the past remind you of being stuck in the house because you're off sick from school? For me, Laverne and Shirley. Definitely reminds me of being off sick from school. And The Time, The Place, Kilroy, This Morning. Not really afternoon TV. I don't really remember afternoon TV.
Mine would be afternoon TV. That'd be all my mum's programmes, like Sons and Daughters, Richmond Hill.
But weren't they on like when you got home from school?
No, some soaps, like, was Shortland Street a bit early on?
Oh, Gareth from Porto's just reminded us.
Mm-hmm.
the heat is on. The time is right. The time for you, for you to play the game. Going for gold. Yeah, that's a, that's
Katie opposite, Marsh said Pebble Mill with Alan Titch Marsh.
Well, Katie, I used to go, as we've spoken about many a time, I used to go home for my lunch. So I would watch Pebble Mill anyway of a school day.
Mark Holt, The Sullivans. That was about 12:30. Running down the street.
Is that The Sullivans? Oh, no, that's...
Country Practice.
Country Practice. Sullivan's is like, something about, like, pushing a cap on someone's head. Yeah. And then so it's like a photo.
And they have a little pop the pose at the photo at the gate.
And then he pushes his hat and they all have a laugh.
Yeah.
Right, let's have a look over here. We've got Crown Court.
Yeah, I remember that. Oh, God, Mum used to watch that.
I don't remember. Was it ITV?
It's very slow. I remember being a bit kid, but nothing happened.
I don't think our aerial picked up ITV.
General Hospital, says Jason Rigby.
Michael Redfern, you've got the wrong end of the stick. He says, why don't
you? I remember Why Don't You.
But Why Don't You was specifically when you were off school.
Was it?
Like for holidays. It wasn't like when you were, it wasn't like a sickie.
You could have been bloody ill in the holidays.
Stop trying to defend bloody Michael Redfern.
Yeah. Well, you're just one-sided, you, Judge Judy.
Scylla says open air.
Open air.
She would, of course, she'd probably call it open air.
Oh, that was open house for Gloria Redfern.
Yeah, I don't remember open air, Scylla. Helen, programmes for schools and colleges. Oh, but you'd avoid them if you were off home, off sick. Paul Esselmont, Pebble Mill, Santa Barbara and Country Practice.
Santa Barbara, that drama, American drama.
Nubs, Pebble Mill, Rainbow, Crown Court, Sons and Daughters.
Yeah.
Lily Law, The Sullivans. Now, this one I never knew of until Alan told me about it. Paint Along with Nancy.
Amazing.
And Take the High Road.
Oh, even more. What an afternoon. What an afternoon of fun.
Pebble Mill and the
Flumps. And if you're from Yorkshire, hello and welcome to the Farmhouse Kitchen.
Pebble Mill and the Flumps, Take the High Road, Rainbow and Pebble Mill, Diagnosis Murder. Oh, you're a young'un. Who's that? Hugh Bonnet.
Yeah, baby programme.
Flying Doctors.
Come outside.
Josh Sadler is talking about the Aer Lingus and British Airways being part of the One World Alliance. My status meant nothing on Aer Lingus.
That's my dog, Jason Ruby says. Tushy Washy says Farmhouse Kitchen.
Oh, that's my dog. I remember that a little bit. Let's go. What do we have?
Bun Moon. Sullivan's, Crown Court.
Oh, there's loads. Oh, it's this question's taken off. Let's have a look. Stop, Look, Listen.
Yep.
What was that one?
Kids Not
got, has that got Wordy in it? General Hospital, Crown Court, Sullivan's, Pigeon Street.
Oh, Pigeon Street, yeah.
Crown Court, Sullivan's, Pebble Mill, Country Practice, Shortland Street. Is it you or is it me?
Do you want a cup of tea down at Shortland Street?
The Sandrolls are saying, That's My Boy. That's My Boy strikes me as being an evening sitcom.
Yeah, unless you're on cable in Granada. Plus. Remember that, Granada?
Philip Jack, Ill Day Programmes, Going for Gold, Sullivan's. This is from Wales. Going for Gold, Pebble Mill, Chain Letters.
Chain Letters with Tom O'Connor. Bum, 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 bum.
Chain Letters.
Was it? No, with Tom O'Connor. Alex. Crosswits.
Alex is Little. So Alex will be thinking of Lenny Bennett for Chain Letters, I think. Take the High Road, The Sullivans. Good Morning with Anne and Nick.
The Young Doctors. That was about 3 o'clock, I think.
Richard Bobbin's Duffer, Ribbons, was on Chain Letters, but the Ted Robbins era.
Oh, okay. Do you remember Quick Lose and Draw?
Win, lose, or draw? Well, yeah, we've spoken about that, because it used to annoy me that the women had to sit on the floor like second-class citizens.
Pipkins, that weird Pip Rabbit.
Jason Rigby thinks it's not the Sullivans, the Sandwells don't mean That's My Boy, they mean That's My Dog. Perinder's mum, when he was ill, used to make him watch all the educational programmes.
Oh, that's harsh, isn't it?
On Beeb 2.
Oh, very harsh, very harsh.
Pipkins, Painting Along with Nancy. Wordy, Wordy was Words and Pictures. Let's Pretend. I used to like a bit of Let's Pretend because I was into drama, so it was like improv. Improv 101. Robin and Rosie of Cockleshell Bay. Well, we're moving into kids' TV now.
Yeah.
We're not strictly sick telly. like Happy Days or Laverne and Shirley.
What's Crystal Tips and Alistair?
Do you not remember Crystal Tips and Alistair?
No.
Crystal Tips has got a massive afro. Alistair's her dog. It's animation, a bit kind of Captain Pugwashy.
15-1. How very educational.
Now, again, 15-1, I think, was about a 3:30, 4 o'clock programme.
It was, yeah. And what,
it was
really long. It was about 45 minutes.
Yeah. And it was Edward W. Robinson, wasn't it?
It was, yeah.
Andrew
O'Connor. Oh, do you remember him?
Yeah, little curly hair. He did the 8:15 from Manchester.
Looks a bit like Johnny Fawn.
Yes, yeah.
Looks a bit like him.
Alex is on a roll. Crosswits, Lucky Ladders, Going for a Song and Pass the Buck.
Pass the Buck. Pass the Buck.
Not there's any more over here, yeah. Seven Network says, does anyone remember the Home Cookery Club?
No, just Farmhouse Kitchen.
Darren Bramley wonders if... it's all moved, so I've missed it. Little House on the Prairie, daytime or weekends. I would say a weekend programme.
Yeah, I don't remember seeing
that. I'd say Sunday mornings. Emotional Urban Homestead. I was never allowed to be off sick until I was a teenager.
What?
And my dad let me have a day off once a month. I only remember during nursery age and the cedar tree.
So you had to go to school all ill, darlings.
Caroline must have been patient X a lot of the time at school.
What, keeps getting everybody the flu?
Spreading, yeah. Lily Law says, it was open air, had Patty Caldwell in it.
It had not, no, darling, I remember.
I can't do Patty Caldwell.
It was something with five. I was on Channel 5 for a bit when that started.
Finger Bobs. Knots Landing. Can't Cook, Won't Cook. That was a...
Oh, God.
That was an off-sick programme,
wasn't
it?
Another one where they say, I've got to make a pudding out of oranges.
Ready, Steady, Cook. We're talking after school, Ready, Steady, Cook.
Yeah.
I think 4:30 BBC Two.
Yeah, Can't Cook,
Won't... too much talent.
Can't Cook, Won't Cook was in the morning, wasn't it?
Yeah, and it always had that one from Yorkshire who says potatoes.
Got the potatoes!
What's his name?
Brian something.
Brian Turner.
Got your potatoes.
When there were a rumour he had like a young tart in London and his wife in Yorkshire.
Oh.
Allegedly. Ormond Cheap. Oh. I remember the name, but I don't remember what it was about. Was it a bird and a worm?
That must be somebody young, isn't it?
No, because I remember Ormond Cheap. I think it was a bird and a worm. Let's have a look. Anyone out there's loads. Oh, so much. Bursting through the door. In between Scylla mentioning Give Us a Clue and Lily Law talking about Kenneth Kendall, bursts in Paul McFarlane saying, where good evening, everyone. Have I missed much? And then in comes Nubs with Tickle on the Tum.
For those who follow us, they'll know that Paul keeps little birds.
Yes, cockatoos.
Cockatoos. And he's got the cutest little bird called Chico. Did you see it?
Chico dances to the nuns, doesn't he?
Chico dances to our singing, doesn't he?
Yeah.
And he's a little disabled bird. I think he's got a little foot missing, hasn't he?
He has.
And he's ever so sweet. And they sent us a video of Chico dancing. Oh, it broke my heart. It broke my heart. So sweet. It's Chico time.
Scylla would like to remind us that her friend Dale's supermarket sweep was daytime
today. Oh, day of that day, Spaghetti Hoops Dale. Ba, da, da, da. Fabric conditioner Dale.
Check it out. Now, if you were on supermarket sweep, what would your system be on that final sweep?
Small, expensive things. No?
No, I would... All I'd have in my mind is Dale's shopping list... And inflatables.
Oh, the inflatables. But a banana, £25. A guitar, £100.
But getting his shopping list was always worth it. And the pick and mix. Wasn't there? Couldn't you go and do the pick and mix?
Yeah. And they had little coloured
and if you got a certain tins. Weight. Like, yeah, battered tins.
No, there was tins in a thing where you had to get your colour, didn't you?
Yeah. I'd go for all of that.
Yeah.
And then, if I had any time left, I'd be... Things like nappies.
Razor blades. They're £5 and they're not that big.
Blocks of cheese.
Batteries. Don't go for big bundles of kitchen roll. Mind you, that's gone up in price, hasn't it?
Scream Queen has just burst through as well. That's Felicia from America.
Oh, hello, darling.
It's Scream Queen. You missed a very spooky introduction to the show today with lots of quotes from horror movies.
Scream Queen must be enjoying this week.
Yeah, it is. It's the spooky season.
Halloween.
Chris Perinder, who is ex-supermarket staff, not supermarket sweep, but supermarket staff, says, head for the frozen turkeys.
Yeah, 30 quid or 40 quid a pop. Those were polystyrene though, weren't they?
Emotional Urban Homestead, turkeys, Dale's shopping list, pick a mix. Mm. Job done.
Yeah.
Get to those checkout girls.
Yeah.
Pip says if he was off sick and his mother was home, she'd make him watch Crossing Over with John Edwards on Living TV.
Oh, I was watching that not long ago.
Well, Alan's been watching a lot of Mia Dolan.
Mia Dolan. Do you know Mia Dolan? Because she's a bit different from other psychics.
No, it's because Divinity's going to be at the bingo on Saturday.
Divinity's making a live appearance, her first ever. And I've been looking at Doris Stokes. Oh, she was a bit iffy. Can you come in the light now? Come in the light. I can't see you because you're sort of read them.
What, like to then see what age they are and
well,
check
does,
if it's
she like did,
your
like,
mum.
She does like a reader.
Your mum's dead or your nan's.
Yeah, she does like the Barbican. So there's like hundreds in there. So she's like, come closer, love.
And Molly Morton's going to be appearing, isn't she?
Yeah, she's a
lovable Cockney psychic.
Oh, she Cockney?
Yeah. She's she appears in Divinity's psychic hotline video.
Oh, yeah.
But she's got a new look. But she's going to be there. Just like your mum. Just friendly like your mum. Having a little chat with you. I was trying on glasses tonight, wasn't I? To try and get ready for her.
Yeah.
Scream Queen. Question of the week. What TV shows remind you of being ill off school? Because it'll be American things, we don't know. And Gabby Chassie, what about you? What was on telly in the US of A during the day?
We only had three channels. Well, I did.
Oh, here we go. Scream Queen says, when I was sick, I loved watching Monty Hall, Let's Make a Doll. I'm not sure if you... Because of all the contestants wearing costumes, it was always like Halloween. We don't know the programme, Scream Queen. Oh. Beth and Williams would like me to know that you can only have one inflatable. So me going for all the inflatables would be pointless.
Is that what you said you do?
All the inflatables. Dale no, shopping list,
no,
pick and mix.
One, but it could be £25 banana or...
Paul McFarlane says, Chico is watching and dancing with us now.
Oh, Chico.
Well, you know our little... Chico. Chico.
It's Chico time.
Darren Bramley says, we used to have a director on GMTV who, when the producers wouldn't say what was coming next and it all went quiet, he would say, who do you think I am? Doris Stokes. Darren, you'd have to wear headphones. Of course you would. I was going to say, did you have to wear an earpiece? But
me and Darren earlier were talking about how that on the day of our show... We don't drink at all, do we? We don't drink alcohol or...
A little bit of water.
A little bit of water, because we're all trussed up, you see. So going to the loo is very, very difficult.
We're trussed up and things are tucked away, Darren.
Yeah, we've got like body...
Things are in places where they shouldn't be.
Body shapers and things that pull me in. So going to the toilet, we went out for 5 hours. And of course, Darren says, well, he's the same. 3 hours on a...
Of course you are. 3 hours on GMTV. You can't nip off for a wee in the break. Just in case. Right, let's have a look. So, I have been playing around with artificial intelligence this past week. And I've been trying to get it to draw Sherrie and Brandi. There's lots of different ones coming up. So, I'm going to show
them.
And
again, being in the Wig and Slingback, you see this first.
Alan hasn't seen most of these. So we thought
we'd share some of them with you.
So there's a variety of results. Let's see. Alan's going to give his honest opinions.
Can you tell the viewers what you type in to get these?
So typing.
You don't have to be polite.
Can you create an image of two Caucasian drag queens outside a traditional British pub in the style of a 1960s cartoon? or 1950s cartoon or 1980s cartoon. So change that bit. One of them is very pretty, but is overweight, is wearing a leopard print dress. I don't think I say but. I think and is overweight and is wearing a leopard print dress and has big, curly, dark hair.
But you say pretty.
The other one has a beard, great legs, and is wearing a yellow dress and feathers. And then sometimes that one changes to has a grey beard or changes to is wearing glasses and has a beard. Loads of, it brings up a load of stuff that's not right, but then it brings up some fun ones. So I've got you the fun ones. So let's have a look. Alan's not seen these yet. There's one.
Oh, I look like I'm about to burst into tears.
You got a little suitcase in your hand. I don't know why.
I like yours. I just don't like your hair.
Well, I don't know. It looks like we're by a Scarborough pub, though, doesn't it?
Yeah.
It always draws us with boobs. And I've tried to say no boobs, no breasts. But then it says...
Well, I want my breasts included.
Okay, so... That one's all right, though, isn't it?
I spent a lot of money on them.
That one's all right. They're sort of right with what they've done there.
Yeah, I look
there.
A bit miserable. I love that one, but it's really, really polite.
I don't know
you
what
look,
happened
you
with
look
that
You look great
one.
There. Grey beard. Yeah, the grey beard.
But I haven't got a grey beard. I've got a dark beard.
You haven't? You've not looked in the mirror today.
Let's have a look at some others. So you like that one, but it's not right.
It's not. Mine's completely wrong, isn't it? Jesus. Oh. Again, you look great. I look like a miserable.
You are. Look at that misery face.
And I don't have curly hair.
Look at my sassiness.
What's the sort of things? Is it, are you burping or something?
Or them little yellow things.
Is that sparkle?
Might be sparkle. It's weird. Sometimes it gives us lots of...
See, that's good for you. That one's good for you.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Let's have a look.
Oh, my God. You look like Big Bird.
Look at your share hair.
I don't mind that one, actually, because I've got big fat legs.
Can I show you your little feet?
Yeah. Oh, I love my little bare feet. My legs are like those turkey legs that Chris eats in Disney.
Here we go, another one.
Jesus. I like yours. I look like I'm just going to come out of prison.
You do look a bit like that, though. You'd never wear a strap like that, would you?
Sorry?
You'd never wear a strap like that, would you?
No, look at them. Look at those little tiny bingo wings under my arm. I like that one.
I like that one. It's not too bad, is it?
Yeah.
Although I've not got stubbly boobs.
They've given me a little bangle as well. And I've got fat fingers, look. Yours tend to be very sort of hairy.
I think it's because I've got a beard, then they just give me hair.
Mm. Oh, I look like I'm about 80. Jesus. Well, it's giving me the chins. That's correct.
Do you not think that looks like Sherry Stump?
It does. Who am I kidding? Yeah, it does.
Hang on, this one.
It's most probably the most accurate one.
This next one. Sherry looks really canceled.
But you look massive. You're not like that.
You look proper like estate here.
Oh, do I?
What's the estate that Mishmash used to work on?
Brand's Home. But there's nothing wrong with Brand's Home if you're watching.
I think you look a bit Brandsome here.
Oh, yeah, a bit tussled, don't I? Morning after. I like the fact they're giving us little glasses of beer.
For our dainty little lady's hands. Not bad, though. Quite divine, isn't it?
Yeah, it's very, very divine.
Let's have a look. Any more?
I don't come out too bad on these, really, to be honest.
Not too bad.
Yours are a little... Oh, see, that, again, for me is fine, but yours is just a little bit...
Like I've got, like, them weird eyes.
And you got really thick glasses on. You don't wear glasses as Brandy, though, do you?
No, but I thought maybe it'll then give me... Because when I was doing without glasses, it was making me too hunky, wasn't it? Tushy Rushworth says it's not Brand's Home, it's Orchard Park that you look like.
Oh, is that the... Oh, Jesus. That's very Preston Road. Is that Seaside postcard?
Must be, yeah.
You look good, though.
Do I?
Yeah.
I'm too big, aren't I? Let's have a look. Any more? That one I quite liked.
I like that one. If your beard wasn't as dark.
I could make it a bit dark, less dark.
Is that Brighton? Oh, come on. That's a bit...
Does it not look like us?
Yours, yeah, but mine doesn't.
Right, now I've got... there's a few here that are good, and then it goes... let me show you the good ones, and then it goes ropey. That's good.
I like that one. I like the fact I've got a proper tankard as well now. Jeez. We both look really pissed, don't we? We look like slappers there, proper slappers. Oh my God, look at you.
I don't know why I'm in that big frock. Hang on.
Oh my word. Why am I on a stool?
Because you're little.
What? That means if that stool wasn't there, I wouldn't even reach the height of the bar, would I? Oh, wow.
That one all right?
Yeah, that's proper. We're getting there. And you got a ciggy in your hand. That's not too bad.
That sort of looks like me, doesn't it?
Oh, no. We're not like that. Gee, I do have a moustache. God, that looks like that fella that's married to...
Megan Mullally?
No, he's married to Pauline Collins. What's his name?
John Alderton. I think that's it, my loves. Let's have a look. I've got another couple where they're having cigs. At that one, I think they're having cigs.
Oh, that's pretty.
That's quite nice, isn't it?
Yeah, that's like a sort of sailor tattoo, isn't it?
Yeah. And I think that... Is that?
Oh, we like that one, don't we? We've seen that before.
Yeah. So, if anyone fancies having some AI fun, try and get them to draw us in any guise and send them our way because it's really good fun. And I do it on Bing AI's image creation, which you don't have to pay for. So, you can have some fun doing that. Let's have an advert break. And when we come back from our advert break, we'll be back with our...
Top five.
So, let's have some ads. Bye.
Wow. Talk about sheer terror. Well, what did you think so far? Listen, this side is about to come to an end, but I want you to be sure and flip over to the other side where the best of Hollywood beckons. I'm going to freshen up a little bit, so I'll see you on the other side. Honey, why don't we get some more wine, more hors d'oeuvres, more everything?
Okay.
Once upon a time, a little princess with a nasty cold found it hard to breathe. Then the good fairy appeared with Vicks Vapor Rub, good effective medicine. She rubbed it on the little princess and it did her good. It cleared her blocked nose, soothed her cough, and she fell asleep till morning.
For a child with a cold, it's love. For a mother, it's good effective medicine. Vicks Vapor Rub.
I've been sweet. And I've been good. I've had a whole full day of motherhood. But I'm gonna have an Aviance night.
Prince Machiavelli brings you Aviance, a radiant new perfume that lasts through the night. And what a way to start it.
We're gonna have an Aviance night.
Oh yeah, we're gonna have an Aviance night.
Aviance.
Introducing Spin Slicer by Ronco, the fancy food cutter. Watch, take a beetroot or a turnip, put it in the spin slicer and spin. Look how fast and easy it is to use. Spin slice potatoes for frying or for casseroles. Spin slice carrots or radishes for a beautiful garnish. Spin slice onions for salads or for any kind of sandwich. Spin slicer makes food look more appetizing than ever before. Spin slicer, a perfect Christmas gift, only £4.99 at Woolworths and most fine stores.
We're happy to announce the arrival of a new baby. We've called her simply New First Love because she's more natural than ever. First of all, feed her,
then gently squeeze her and see little tears run down her cheeks. Then she wets her nappy, just like a real baby. New first love feeds, cries little tears, and wets her nappy.
New first love, a very lovable new baby doll from Pedigree.
Everyone, smile! Mother, big smile! Nice.
Where's the photograph?
Well, I'll have to take the film to be developed.
What, no photograph?
No photograph?
No photograph.
Here, dear, is the photograph.
With a Polaroid 1000 instant camera, just push the button, and in minutes you'll enjoy your picture in brilliant colour.
Now that's a photograph.
Polaroid 1000, the world's simplest camera.
Should be here in 4 minutes.
Don't fuss, Mum. You know what I like.
Blooming tight is out here, Sarge. Put the kettle on.
When you find yourself with a hungry moment, just put the kettle on and make a pot noodle. Tender pasta noodles with vegetables and soya pieces in a rich, savoury sauce. Choose from 5 tasty flavours and eat hot from the pot.
Now mind your shirt, Gerald.
So try pot noodle today. Now in new sweet and sour and cheese and tomato flavours.
In the night, let the windows of your house, especially of your chamber, be closed. When you be in your bed, lie a little on your left side and sleep on your right side.
Hi, I'm back. And so are you. You know, I feel as though I know you. Well, at least we share some of the same tastes. Oh, I'm sorry about the cheese puffs. I ran out. But I still have quiche. Well, anyway, I promised you the best of Hollywood at under $20 prices.
Hello and welcome back. We've got our top 5 turbans on again.
Which means we mean business, don't we?
We mean business. Mine's not even. How do I get that in the middle of my head? There. I wish you could watch the adverts with us, because Alan's little commentary to the adverts is always very funny.
Vicks, Vapor Rub. That brings back memories, laying on the sofa, smelling of that.
Should have heard him during the pot noodle advert.
Oh.
He was livid.
They never looked like that.
And then he went, I remember my first pot noodle.
Yeah, it was at my nana's house. It was lunchtime. And it was pot noodle, kettle, lovely.
And we were also talking about when people started showing off because they had a Polaroid camera at like a family party.
They were muted, dull. And I said, you have to shake your shame, didn't you?
Yeah, I don't think you had to shake them. I think people used to just shake them, though, didn't they?
You didn't get many, did you? I remember wanting you to rip something off. No?
That's like...
Something else.
That's when they do Polaroids on telly stuff, isn't it? They rip something off.
Yeah.
And shake it. No, it just come out, didn't it? Our family friends, the Bruffs, who always had a New Year's Eve party, they had a Polaroid, I think, at one of the New Year's Eve parties, and were showing off with it. Mr. Perinder would like to know whatever happened to cheese and tomato pot noodle. I'd like a cheese pot noodle.
Yeah, they sort of...
I think they did macaroni cheese once, didn't
yeah.
they?
Yeah. And they did some weird flavours and they just kept to the boring ones, like chicken and sweet corn or something.
Yeah. People might have missed last week our little turbans. They're presents from our friends.
From Bangkok.
From Bangkok. So we were wearing them for our top 5. Lily Law says the early Polaroids had a rip-off cover.
Yeah.
Paul McFarlane says, never mind Chico time, it's turban time. So, top 5, continuing on the theme of camp, because the turbans led us down a little camp road.
Yeah.
We'd like to talk about camp villains, camp baddies. And for the Americans who don't know what camp means, because it doesn't translate there, it's not your summer camp.
No.
Camp baddies is Camp is like flamboyant, over the top, fabulous.
Yeah, over the top.
Extrovert, extra. You know, just a little bit camp. So some that came through. Paul Esselmont said Joan Collins as Alexis.
Oh, yeah, one baddie. Yeah.
I'm not going to mention if any of ours are coming up here. Ming the Merciless. Forgot about Ming.
Yeah, well, there's loads
Ming's of, proper camp.
There's loads of camp carrot baddies in that.
Baby
there?
Jane.
Yeah.
Yeah, Ming's. Hasn't Ming got like a sassy daughter?
Yeah, she's sort of sex star, isn't she? Yeah. Remember, she's like full of tinsel.
Yeah, and she wants Timothy Dalton, doesn't she?
And then he's got that sort of assistant, that woman who goes, "Wash that floor with Ajax."
Diana from V. Yeah, proper camp Diana from V. She was like Alexis. Mm. Emperor Ming again. The child catcher from Chitty Chitty Bang Bang. Kenneth Williams in Carry On, Don't Lose Your Head.
Yep.
Charles Hawtrey in Anything Carry On. Uncle Herbert. Kenneth Camp Uncle. And head of the Mafia in Benidorm. Uncle Herbert. Played by Ken Morley.
Oh, I don't remember him.
The Hooded Claw from Penelope Pitstop.
Yeah.
Alan Rickman as the Sheriff of Nottingham. Mm. Cersei Lannister. This is from Gemma, the other side of Aldi.
Yeah.
For the Glare, the Frocks, the Family Drama, and Burning Down the Citadel.
Yeah.
And Ming the Merciless as well. There are some seminars.
David Moore saying Liberace.
Liberace is a camp villain. Camp baddie. Liberace's camp, but he's not a baddie. Skeleton in Super Ted was well camp.
Yeah.
He was proper. All Tex, what are we going to do? Melvin Hayes, I think. Right, so we've chosen our top five, and some of these came up in your lists as well. So, in at number five, for me, Jamie, Servalan. You don't really remember Servalan, do you?
Is she holding a BAFTA there?
She's holding a little camp mask with a white dove on it. But you can tell she's fierce and camp, can't you?
I remember her voice.
Yeah, look at her. She was very theatrical.
And she's asked for red tights, hasn't she, or pink tights?
So she often spoke like she had a plum in her mouth. She was a proper sort of Chichester festival. Everything was a little bit much.
And gold shoes.
Yeah. Servalan. Anyone else, any Servalan memories? Some of yours coming up. Servalan from Blake 7. Helen says it. I'd kill to look like her. Jacqueline Pierce, the actress, sadly missed. And then Helen said, yes. Liberace. Tushy Rushworth says Liberace played a Batman villain. Tushy Rushworth also, Servalan was one of his, and he says she was very sexy. Was she the sort of like sexy villain that would give young boys a little stirring?
Perhaps when they wanted a MILF. Yeah.
I don't think she's a MILF. There's nothing.
Well,
like,
she's an older lady.
But there's
she?
Nothing like mummish about her.
No, but she's older to a young.
Dale
young
says
boy.
She was brilliant. Dale Ibbotson, she was brilliant. So I think she, like, you know, lots of young boys wanted to be with her, and then lots of young boys wanted to be her. But yeah, she was fabulous. David Moore says he was trying to explain camp to the Americans and said Liberace kind of sums up camp.
Yeah.
Yeah. Right, so my number five is Servalan from Blake 7. Alan's number five is, and this has been mentioned a couple of times on both sides of the comments.
Oh, teabag. I'm on my teabag was Georgina Hale. On the right.
With the little boy.
Yeah. And I think younger people is there from Emmerdale. But the one Georgina Hale, I spoke like, oh. She's in a 1 foot in the grave.
I kind of don't remember Teabag.
Do you not remember her?
Only vaguely.
And you know it's just tea bag. No E and an A.
No.
No, it's just tea bag.
What was she? A witch?
Yeah, she's a naughty witch. And obviously there was lots of references to teapots and tea leaves.
But there was T-shirt as well, which I think is that boy, isn't it?
Yeah, he was a little bit annoying him.
And I think the girl, the one who now is the landlady of the Queen Vic, or was the landlady of the Queen Vic, I think she was another
one. The kids were really over the top.
Chris has said teabag.
Yeah.
Nibbles.
So you either had a Georgina Hale teabag or a thingy from Emmerdale teabag.
Both Emotional Urban Homestead and Lucy Linda LaHughes have said that Servalan was a vilf.
Villain.
SDM says, surely the Americans have camp like Jack and Will and Grace. They do. They get it. They just don't call it camp. Because camp for them is summer camp.
Kitch.
That kids go to. No, I don't, effeminate. I don't know if there's a word that... I don't know if there's a word that... Scream Queen, if she's in, still. Scream Queen, is there a word that Americans would use instead of camp to describe people like Jack in Will and Grace or Liberace? Is there a word? Nibbles and Bubbles says, this is Bubbles, I think, on this side. That's Diana from Emmerdale. Yeah. Diane from Emmerdale. David Moore says, Servalan started my thing for women with short hair.
And also, my Hammer Horror friends out there will know that Georgina Hale was in a Hammer House of Horror.
Was she?
Yeah.
Look at her little signature on that picture.
Yeah.
Now, have you noticed that this teabag near me and Servalan are wearing very similar outfits?
Well, I've noticed that the Teabag 2 has opted for a bit more razzle-dazzle, hasn't she?
I think Teabag 2's had a little bit more of this spent on her.
I think she said, because...
Teabag 1 is a little bit like some of the amateur dramatic pantomimes we've seen.
Well, if you didn't like Robin Hood.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And you'd be the. It would smell a little bit of like a damp basket.
Yeah, she's got a braided. She's got a braided headband. That's it.
Yeah.
Whereas Diane from Emmerdale's got.
She's got
a Christmas tree in her head.
She's got bespoke headgear.
Yeah. And a gold teapot service. Look.
What do you reckon, Georgina Hale's whole outfit sort of smelt of when it came out of the basket? The
mothballs.
Yeah, it did. From the fancy dress, from Trish in the fancy dress stores.
Yeah.
And then, of course, this one's bespoke. And
I've seen in charity shops, you know the thing on her head? I've seen curtain tie backs like that.
I bet it is one.
Oh, I'll use that for my curtain tie back.
Ribbons has said, was it Hammer House Horror Lucky 13?
It was, my darling, yes. And she was a tenant in the house where he lived.
Now, luckily for us, we seem to have a tea bag... expert in the room. Simon B has said from 1985 to 1989, Tallulah Bag was played by Elizabeth Estensen. In 1990, Estensen left the show and Tallulah Bag was replaced by her sister, Tabitha Bag, played by Georgina Hale.
Oh, so Georgina's not the first tea bag.
So there are three tea bags.
Oh.
She was a sorceress, apparently. Paul McFarlane says he's a camp villain because he's missing the live bingo. You're just a camp hero, Paul, not a camp villain. Let's have a look. So my number four is Ursula from The Little Mermaid, but you could pretty much replace Ursula with all Disney villains because they are all very camp, aren't they?
Well, this is designed on one particular, which we'll talk about later.
Yeah. The makeup, the look is meant to be divine.
But the drag queen. Is she like the first sort of obese character?
I don't know. We've got Nubs in the house. Nubs, obese Disney characters. Who else is there? One of the... There's Baloo, the bear. One of them little mice in Cinderella.
One of the little things in Sleeping Beauty is a little bit chubby, isn't she?
I think so. But you've got Disney villains, like the one from Robin Hood, the king, the Robin Hood villain.
Sheriff Nottingham?
Yeah, he's as camp as Knickers.
Sheriff Nottingham.
Scar in The Lion King, camp as Knickers. Ursula. But Ursula's my favourite because she says, well, I think she's saying it there, what about the power of body language?
You know, we did this as a creation, didn't we?
Yeah, Alan painted himself that purple.
And it was done in like
out in the garden.
It was like an October day, wasn't it?
It was dead cold.
So cold.
I was in a little bikini as a little mermaid. And Alan made all the tentacles out of...
Bin bags.
It looked great.
And what do they call it? Bubble wrap. I painted all my body purple.
Some teabag news. Teabag 2 had a lisp. Georgina Hale had the number 666 on her head in Hammer House.
She did.
Diane from Emmerdale was the first teabag from 1985 to the early 90s.
Oh, have I got it wrong?
So it's the other way around, yeah.
Really? Yeah. Oh, wow. Wow, yay.
Fairy Godmother, she was Chubster. Winnie the Pooh, Chubbo. Hades in Hercules is very camp, says Chris Perinder. The British guy from Pocahontas, very camp. Now, there's a film of The Little Mermaid, and Melissa McCarthy plays Ursula.
Yeah, I saw some footage of her backstage getting made up.
Yeah, but the makeup's shocking, isn't it? Mm. They don't do the makeup very well, considering it's a... Anyway, Ursula, you couldn't have a camp villain without her on there.
No.
Now, Alan's next one. I don't know if she's camp, you know.
Well, put the picture on. She walks around with a beret, leather gloves, tattoos... and a string of pearls. What more camp do you need?
But isn't she butch? Which is the opposite of camp.
Well, I think she's camp because she's wearing those outfits.
Do you remember what she gives them to what she does for them in the cafe when they go there?
Water. Actually. It's wet, isn't it? Well, I've got a thing for Mama Fratelli.
So it's Mama Fratelli for those who don't know.
I might have shoehorned her into my camp top five.
Yeah.
But the outfit... It's like a uniform of camp. The sort of French, I don't know what the pearls would represent.
Pearls are quite British, aren't they?
Yeah.
And of course she's Italian because she's Mama Fratelli.
Yeah. So there's a lot of campery in there.
Emotional Urban Ope said, quite bluntly tells me, if Alan says she's camp, she's camp.
Yeah.
When she pulls out all them
the beads,
the things from mouth, when she slaps his face and he spits out a couple more gems.
But I think you can be butch and camp.
Who knows?
Look what you do.
I'm not butch.
You can when you
there
want.
There we go. Look at what Chris has said.
The only thing we serve is tongue.
He's going to cut it off, isn't it? Isn't he?
Yeah. She's a baddie that I love.
Do you remember what she sings to Sloth? Yeah, and he goes, fall, you dropped me, mama.
Oh, mama, that
is. Mama didn't mean to. The Goonies is a great movie, Josh Sadler. Goonies is one of my favourite movies. SDM says, Julie Walters as Pat Bedford in Pat and Margaret as camp, a camp villain, camp baddie. And Claude LaCruz, they quite rightly corrects me and says there's nothing British about Coco Chanel and she was pearls. Let's have a look. Number three. Camp. Baddie.
Oh, do the Catwoman. She was in last week's, wasn't she?
So Catwoman. You can have any of the Catwomen's. You can have, maybe not Halle Berry, but you can have your Michelle Pfeiffer. You can have your Eartha Kitt. You can have your...
I don't know what her name is.
The one from Tu Wong Fu, Thanks for Everything, Julie T. Newmar.
Newmar? See there, I want to fawn like a cat.
But most Batman villains, I think, would class. I'd class as camp.
Yeah,
especially in this series. Mm. Also, I was going to put her in there, but I've not seen enough of it. Joan Collins plays a Batman baddie called the Siren.
Really?
Yeah, and she has a harp. And she can sing like in 12 octaves or something. So she goes really high like, and then you hear this little squeak. And when she does the little squeak, people get like put under her spell.
Did that not work out then?
The Siren.
Yeah.
Well, she was only in the one. I thought, well, Catwoman's bigger. But other camp villains in there was like an Egyptian one, wasn't there?
Yes.
Caesar.
Yeah.
There was
Poison Ivy.
Poison Ivy's camp.
Joker was
the
camp.
Joker's camp. The Riddler's very camp.
Yeah, that was very camp.
Chris has said Cesar Romero with the Joker. Paul McFarlane says, butch and camp, that's me. Julie T. Wallace, She-Devil. Is she a camp villain? Because again, I'd say she's butch. But there is something, there's something camp about Mary Fisher.
Mary Fisher, I would say, is more camp than...
And I'd say Mary Fisher is a baddie.
Well, she's a baddie because she steals a bobo from her, doesn't she?
So I'd say Mary Fisher is the camp baddie in that.
Yeah.
Julie T. Wallace has come up a lot there, but great. I would say she's butch. She's great not drama. Camp. I think we'll have another list of butch villains.
I'm not too keen on the film with Roseanne Barr.
Emotional Urban Homestead has said Jaws the Shark is camp. Have you been drinking tonight, Caroline?
He's got no beret or a pearl necklace.
What's camp about Jaws? Right, let's...
I'm going to have words with you at the weekend here.
Alan's number three is... Now, this is camp.
Oh. Before our days of Isolation Creations end, I will be recreating Ursa. I need to. I've got the wig. I've got a roll of bin bags. So, and the black nail varnish. That's all I need.
Now, to throw a spanner in the works, I think if we do create this, I'll have to be Ursa.
Well, if you do, I will make sure I'm Ursa another day. Because I think mine will be like the AI.
No, I'll be...
A little bit weird.
I'll be Terrence Stamp. Because he's got a beard, doesn't he, in it?
You can be Ursa at all.
No, I'd be...
If I do that scene, you can be the snake.
I'm already Lois Lane in something, aren't I?
Are you?
Yeah.
Are you?
The love boat. The love boat? And I look quite like her.
Yeah, with your cigarette and your glasses.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, forgot about that. But I must remember the slash in the arm, look.
Dale Ibbotson says he's sat next to Caroline. He's no idea what she's on tonight with Jaws being camp. Philip Jack says, I've got the beard for Zod.
I mean, the next Halloween party I'm invited to, I'm going as Ursa.
Gabby Chessie has said, this is the one I was... King Tut from Batman. Victor Bueno played the camp King Tut on Batman, and he was also the neighbour in Baby Jane.
Oh, no, he's the guy that has lessons from her.
Yeah, is that not the neighbour? Oh, no, the neighbours.
He gives her lessons.
Yeah. Helen says, now Alan will agree with you here. Helen from Hull, who we're seeing at the weekend, says, I was really scared of that floating triangle prison.
Oh, where they're going to Phantom Zone.
Yeah.
Helen, do you remember when they're flying out and they're going, we didn't mean it. Oh, sorry. If we come back.
Do you remember the first prison they're in is three spinning hula hoops?
Yeah.
And then they get put in that Phantom Zone and off they go. And that's
flying off.
And that's in Superman 1.
But what breaks it? Can you remember what breaks it?
Is it Pie in the Sky's nuclear bomb?
Yes. On a French lift. From the Eiffel
From the
Tower.
Eiffel Tower.
You're being freed, so shut up.
Now, I think... I know, I was going to say, did Caroline Ibbotson mean Jaws from Bond? Because Jaws from Bond could be a little bit camp.
Oh, no, yes.
But
sorry, Caroline.
No, she says Jaws the Shark.
Oh, okay.
But Jaws with the gold teeth, with the metal teeth, is a little bit camp when he falls in love with that.
Look at you, trying to help her out there.
I know. Let's have a look. Any others? Scarred for Life, says Helen, with...
Phantom Zone.
Yeah. SDM says, I'm not sure who SDM is either, but SDM's been very chipper tonight. SDM, tell me your first name so we don't keep calling you SDM. SDM has said, I've just realised who Jamie looks like in that turban. It's the Behemoth from Dark Season.
What's that?
Oh, I don't know what that is. And then he or they or she clarifies it with saying she was Camp Baddie too.
Yeah.
Blofeld in James Bond. And then Caroline's come back with saying, no, I did mean the shark. And she's standing by it.
Well, let her stand by it. Cause...
Jaws 3 is camp. And the shark might be camp in that.
There's nothing come about a shark, doll, is there, really?
Maybe in Jaws 3 it's a little bit camper because it gets a bit of a personality.
It's grey.
And there's two sassy dolphins in Jaws 3.
Well, dolphins could be camp, but a shark.
Dolphins are sexual predators. Did you know that?
Yeah.
Dolphins will push you against the side of the pool and try and have you. Right. We're at my number two.
Yes.
My number two is Jareth.
Oh, yeah.
The Goblin King. Came up on a few of your lists. Jareth is camp.
Beautiful.
I mean, the outfit itself, the fact he wants to hang out with Sarah's baby and bring it up as a new Goblin King, the mullet, the leggings.
I mean, would you rather be in Sarah's house or in the...
But you don't want to be with all them goblins and stuff.
Wouldn't you
want
to be with...
No, I'd want to be with Sarah. Sarah's parents are quite... Oh, no, I don't know. Sarah's mum might be dead. Sarah's mum is an actress on Broadway, I think.
Because she's only babysitting, isn't she?
Oh, yeah. Please remind me. What's Sarah's family situation in Labyrinth?
But it's her mum, though, isn't it? That's her little brother, isn't it? Is it not?
But I don't know if it's actually her little brother or her stepbrother. Gemma would like to say that Andy, Gemma's husband, is saying Professor Moriarty from Sherlock, any version.
Oh.
We didn't like Andrew Scott in the Benedict Cumberbatch did we? He wound us up.
I've seen
him in other... he's very camp.
I've seen him in other stuff which I like, but in that he sort of wound me up a bit.
The cod piece is camp in itself. But the fact, I mean, he hangs around with a little, like doing
the ball.
Like magic tricks with a little ball, goes to a sassy little masked ball with Sarah, pops in a song whenever he wants to.
Oh, I'd rather sit on his lap, wouldn't
proper
you?
Camp. No, because I quite like Sarah though, and you know what I like about growing up in America.
Oh yeah.
Is
there a song called Dance Baby Dance?
Dance Baby Dance. Dance Magic Dance.
You know I like that,
dance,
don't you?
Dance Magic Dance Magic. Hey up, lads. Your friend Martin Hyde is
here.
Oh,
here she is.
Hello, my love. We're talking about our top five camp baddies. You've missed some of Alan's classics, including Ursa from Superman.
Yep.
Mama Fratelli.
Yep.
And Teabag from Children's Television.
Teabags. Yeah, I think David Bowie is beautiful.
Chris Perinda says, Sarah has a step-mom. Sarah's mum, I think, is an actress and is maybe on tour with the show. Scream Queen, as awesome as Bowie was, can you imagine how awesome Divine would have been in this role? Scream Queen... Is that just fancy, or are you telling us that Divine was considered for this role? Because if Divine was considered for the Goblin King, would he have been great? Would it have been a bit Muppets Take Manhattan?
I don't know.
And maybe it's...
And he died by now.
Maybe why he didn't do it. Look at this little goblin's face.
You see, I like those little things. I liked his little helmet.
When we were in lockdown, we were going to do Dance Magic Dance. We were going to lip sync it.
And I had put away in the shed about 4 metres of plastic. Do you remember?
Oh, yeah, to be Sarah in her ball gown.
Because to me, her dress was like made out of plastic.
Yeah. And I was going to be the Goblin King. And then we were going to have Alan in a little striped striped onesie as the baby. And then we'd be various goblins.
You know what I like in that.
Martin says, are you not my mate then, Jamie? Of course I'm your friend, my darling. But I was pointing out to Alan that you'd arrived.
Do you like a dolly? Do you like a dolly?
I do. I love that bit. And then she almost falls for it, and then she doesn't, and she escapes. Mm. Stephen's favourite movie, Labyrinth.
Oh, is it?
One of mine. It's up there. Dark Crystal, I think, might pip this to the post for me. But yeah, Jareth from The Goblin King, my number two camp baddie. Alan's number two camp baddie, Scream Queen.
Babs Johnson. I can't believe she's called Babs Johnson in this film.
I can't believe she's called Babs Johnson.
But we'll call her Lady Divine in Pink Flamingos, who's the Queen of Filth. And she didn't have run amok in this film.
Look at her, how amazing she looks there.
I know.
What's the story of this film?
I'm not doing any spoilers.
Okay. What's...
I've got Egg Lady in it.
That's it?
Lady's Massey's Egg Lady. And she lives in a little trailer.
Did you you base your hair on this for that photo you took? The little video you made? Or was that not this look?
What video?
The video you made, Martin.
No, the wig came like that. I bought it off Vinted.
Ah.
Yeah.
Scream Queen says she's just fantasizing about Divine being the Goblin King. Mm. Totally alone in that observation. Is anyone able to Google who else was up for the role of the Goblin King? Who else did they consider? Philippe Jacques Fortinbras says Gavin from Evil Aliens was quite camp. Yeah, but he was a goodie, not a baddie. In fact, he was the ultimate goodie because he sacrificed himself to save the world.
In fact, Divine plays a lot of baddie villains.
Look at Divine's norks.
Because Dawn Davenport's quite bad. She's not bad in polyester.
Edna Turnblad's not bad.
Mm?
Edna Turnblad. Oh, no. She's not bad. She's lovely.
I was watching Divine's documentary when you were away. And they're interviewing Ricky Lake. And she said that Divine was a little bit cool with her at first.
Oh, really?
Yeah. She was like, oh, yeah, she didn't really take to me. And then, because Ricky Lake was a little chubby girl, Divine sort of took her under a little wing a bit later on and said, come on, let's go and eat a pie. Let's go and have a Sunday roast. Let's go to the canteen and eat. So they sort of...
bonded over became food. Became
friends over eating meals.
Ah.
So, and then in the end, they were friends.
Now, Divine, I think, did Divine die quite soon after Hairspray?
Yeah, he died the day before he was going to start rehearsal for... an American sitcom.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Was he... Oh, I do kind of know that story.
He was going to be...
Someone's uncle. Was he in Roseanne?
No, it wasn't Roseanne. It was...
Married with Children.
I think it was like Married with Children, I think. Or Family of... No, Family.
I'm not sure.
Anyway, it was something like that. And he was going to be the uncle. And he was so looking forward to it, but he died the night before.
Oh.
His hotel room.
But Camp Villain? Definitely.
Oh, definitely. Divine.
So we're at my number one.
Yep.
My number one is...
Of course.
Frank Furter. Could you get more camp than a sweet transvestite from Transylvania?
There's a new...
Martin says it's Married with Children.
Married with Children.
That, he was going to be in. Peg Bundy, who's camp.
There's a new... are they called memes?
Memes.
Memes going around saying something like... who made this fox?
Yeah, I think so.
And it said, now, Disney and Fox.
Yeah.
And he said, welcome to... I'm your new Disney princess. Something like that.
Yeah. Amazing. I love Rocky Horror Show. I love Frank Furter. And I think, yeah, he's a villain.
Well, yeah.
Because he's killing people.
Yeah.
He's killing people. And he wants to take over the world, doesn't he, really?
Yeah, he's amazing.
That
film really is a cult classic, isn't it?
Yeah.
You think the amount of people who don't even want to dress up for this. They're happy to go to the cinema and dress up.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know.
Wasn't it a flop originally?
Yeah, I think so. It looked pretty cheap, didn't it?
Yeah.
Pretty cheaply made.
I think it's a flop, and then it sort of got a little underground following, and then it just gets...
We did this at college. We did this at college. And I was the man in the wheelchair.
Dr. Scott.
Because the director, Ian, wanted to do Rock, the singer, Rock. Is it Rock? Oh.
He wanted to do Eddie.
He wanted to do Eddie. So he said, if I do Eddie, can you be Dr. Scott? I said, yeah. And then we were asked to perform it at Leeds, in a venue at Leeds.
Did you have to have your little suspenders on then?
Yeah.
Sizzies and...
So we were doing it while the film was being played, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
And the amount of people that was there dressed up. I was ever so shocked. Because people dress up as every single character, don't they?
Yeah. Chris Perinda fills us in with Sting, Michael Jackson and Prince were all considered for the Goblin King in Labyrinth.
All right.
Tim Curry is a great camp villain always, says Emotional Urban Homestead. He is, isn't he? He's camping. What else is... I'm trying to think what else he's in.
Pennywise.
It is camp. And Home Alone, he's camp. Yeah. Home Alone 2.
Yeah.
Lost in Yonkers. So, Frankenfurter, number one camp villain. And if you've not seen my Frankenfurter, then head to our YouTube channel and find it. Because
You do a really good job of it.
Yeah, I'm really good at it, I think.
Well, must be make that, do that, give that an airing this week, won't
yeah,
you?
Yeah, that'll come out in our little hot Halloween-y things. Let's have a look. Alan's number one camp villain. She pops up no matter what.
She's a reoccurring part of my life.
If only she'd had a turban, she would have been in last week's as well.
Yep.
So who is it for our American friends?
She's called Grotbags. And Jamie was out and about in Scarborough today collecting prizes from some wonderful people who were donating for our show on Sunday. And you met somebody that you thought would know Grotbags, and they didn't, did they?
I've met a few people who don't know Grotbags.
And I was so shocked.
I was speaking to Jade at my work today, who organises a lot of my logistics and my flights and stuff. And I'd sent her a picture of us, and she said, "Oh, what's Alan dressed up as?" And I said, "Grotbags." She said, "Oh, who's that?" These youngsters have no idea who Grotbags is.
So it's my job to re-educate people and say, look out for Grotbags. Look her up. Oh, Chris, you are right. The crocodile was camper than Grotbags, but
wasn't like the gold robot even camper?
No, the crocodile. I'm thinking might have had a handbag. he took. He did speak in a sort of. They were all camper.
A bit like Skeleton.
They were all camp.
I know. It's like a little. It's like a little gay house, isn't it? Grotbags would be like a proper fag hag, though, wouldn't she?
Yeah.
You can imagine going out nightclubbing with Grotbags, and she'd like. She'd be on the prowl for you, wouldn't she?
And if she had a fight with both tea bags, or all three tea bags, she'd win.
I think there are only two tea bags. We just got them the wrong way round. Would, if you went clubbing with grot bags,
yeah.
Would she hang around the bar or would she be on the dance floor?
I think she'd be back and forth, bar to dance floor, bar.
I think she'd have a little booth and she'd be surrounded by queens.
And I think she'd use the gents loo because the women's... Oh, no. Is that right?
Yeah, she'd use the gents because there's always a queue for the women's.
Yeah.
And she'd go in and say something. I don't mind me, fellas. Proper fag hag. She'd drink pints.
Yeah.
She'd go up and try and set you up with people.
Do you know what? She'd have that. You know those things you used to... Well, we used to have at school or college school. And it was Castaway and white Lightning Cider.
What's Castaway?
It's like a tropical punch.
Like what, and you'd mix them?
You mix it, and it was called a blast away. And you only needed one drink a night.
Crop bags and drink blast away.
It was green.
Would that be what she'd be drinking?
Yeah.
I think we've done our top five, haven't we?
We have.
Let me go back to this. Martin's wondering if we've got trousers on.
Well, I'm not standing up because I'm bare-arsed. I'm not. Yeah. Do you think we're bare-arsed?
I'm in my jeans. A lot of people are mentioning Blastaways.
Blastaway. Oh, so you know what I'm talking about. Castaway and white, I think White Diamond or White Lightning.
The dog's there. You can see her back legs.
See a little bot.
Good evening to Erica Deacon, who has just burst in the room now. Super late. Chris Perinda says he used to love a Castaway. SDM says Castaway was amazing. I drank that for years, 1995 onwards.
You see, as a student, you find your drinks that can sort of sort you out for the night, but don't cost very much. And when you couldn't afford a Castaway, Blastaway, yeah, we have a Merry Down Cider.
What do you think I used to drink as a student from the student union bar?
Something with a tonic, with a mixer?
A bottle of white wine, please.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
Chilled.
Yeah, obviously, and I'd get a bucket to pop it in. White wine, gin and tonic, the odd pint, but I wasn't really into pints until I met you.
Oh, we did.
I had to butch it up a bit.
We because in the first year I was in halls, and we for the first term we drank Nuki Brown because we wanted bottles to do homebrew.
Oh, really? You were Alan was dead butch in his first year at university.
I was butch all three years.
It's like Mamma Fratelli, butch and camp. Scream Queen, I'm curious, what do the UK think of Witchy Poo, who is the American Grotbags of the early 70s? I couldn't stand the character. Right, I'm heading to my mobile phone to look up Witchy Poo for you because I can't do it on the internet here because I've got to do it on...
I've heard of witchy poo, but I can't witchy
poo's
visualize.
Witchy poo looks horrible.
My word. My friend Aaron, who does the Rita Webb page, is obsessed with her.
Is that witchy poo?
Is that witchy poo?
She's hideous.
Well, she's meant to be hideous. She's a witch.
Yeah, but that's horrible. That's like the stuff of nightmares.
Well, it's meant to be.
Mine's saying you are Butch.
I am Butch, hi darling. Look at me. In an Hawaiian shirt and a turban. Drinking caramelised biscuit flavoured beer.
He is drinking Butch drinks tonight. Witchy Poo, I think, is from HR Puff and Stuff.
Mama Cass. Who's Mama Cass? Is he calling me Mama Cass?
Maybe, in your little turban.
I love Mama Cass.
Dale Ibbotson has just realised that my jumper is Boba Fett.
No, Becky.
She's there.
Yeah.
It is. It's nice, isn't it, Dale? Mama Cass, then she... Oh, so H... Ah, he's saying Witchy Poo was Mama Cass.
Eh? The actress? Singer?
That's what we're hearing. Was Mama Cass Witchy Poo? I think Mama Cass... Witchy Cat Elliot? Cass Elliot?
You're joking. Have I not known this all my life? What way?
We're going to have to do some research. I think Mama Cass might have been in HR Puff and Stuff, but not... Mama Cass was in the HR Puff and Stuff movie as a witch.
Oh, but it's a different one.
But I'm not sure.
I love Mama Cass.
Nibbles and Bubbles would like to know, is there anyone going on Sunday who isn't called Jason?
There's only two in there.
There's only the two Jasons. But Saturday night, people, is the unofficial Wig and Slingback gathering.
It's going to be very, very intimate. It's going to be lovely. It's just us.
Yeah.
In a little venue.
So,
and we can talk all the retro nonsense that we want.
Yeah. And Martin Hyde will be there. And Martin Hyde says, I know everything.
He knows everything.
He does.
The stories he could tell you.
Now, I had some... A green fucker is a snake bite with blue balls in the days before Blastaways.
Really? So Snakebite and another drink on top of that.
Simon B says, Castaway Killer was £5 a pitcher at university. A bottle of Castaway, a shot of Archer's, then filled to the top with cider.
I remember somebody on TV saying that the reason why snake bites were banned in pubs was because the mixture of cider and lager in your stomach turns it to sort of like a jelly.
I think that's all urban mythos.
And that makes you sort of drunker for longer.
I think it's urban myth. Ian Tushy-Russell says it was Diamond White, Alan.
Yeah.
Cider, must have been.
Diamond White and Castaway.
Witchy Poo was played by Broadway actress Billy Hayes. She was camp, comic and evil. And,
You see, witches are also... Oh, every kid will remember, like, the Oz, the Wizard of Oz witch.
Yeah, do you remember she was the Return to Oz witch? She was even scarier.
Was she?
Yeah, because she took her head off. And she took...
Well,
she
had Wurzel.
She had, like, princess heads, so she could put, like, a pretty head on or take it off and then put an evil head on. I can't remember her name. Mothra? Something like that. No, Mothra's something else. Right, loves. Shall we play a song for the end of the show? We've got a little bit of drink left, so we'll be back for an unofficial...
Little chat.
...lock-in. But it's 9:30, so it's later than normal. So, here's a little finale for you all. We've missed her. She's not been singing for a while. So, we'll
see you next week.
A little bit of classic
and singer. Well, we'll definitely see some of you on Saturday and Sunday.
Saturday night and Sunday. And here's our patron saint from the crypt herself, Ms. Cilla Black.
Where all the... your head on.
Scylla and all them people.
All them hollyheads.
That would have been a good day.
Scylla's camp, isn't she?
Oh, yeah, Scylla. Especially in that outfit.
Lots of people loving a bit of Scylla.
I mean, that must have took quite a while to... Because she's in like a sort of road, like on a street, isn't she, High Street?
They closed down Hollyhead for the day.
And then out on the hills?
Yeah, with the whole of Hollyhead doing a conga.
Conga on rough terrain.
And then she took an old lady out in a lifeboat.
Yeah, even more dramatic action.
Someone, and I can't remember who it was mentioning a show called Pennywise that was on TV.
Mm.
And it was two Scottish women talking about saving your pennies. Mm. And then BG Bear said he's remembered Victoria Wood's version of it, which was called Maconomy.
Oh, that's just spattering me carrot again.
Hello and welcome to Maconomy.
Oh, somebody wrote in and so you could save money by not producing this programme.
A canny notion indeed. Scylla says, what a treat this is for all of you and thank you. Lots of people saying they loved it. Scylla also says, look at all those people, the money LWT spent on me.
You see, that's the difference between Scylla and Jay McDonald.
What?
Because Scylla will do... She'll open it up to the public.
You think Jay McDonald wouldn't?
Have you not watched Cruising with Jay McDonald, where she's just
she
on her own?
Do you want to look at this?
Yeah.
Scylla's willing to do a number with the whole of Hollyhead.
And Jane, when she does, like, Let It Go from
she's
Frozen,
on
she's on her own.
On her own,
Norwegian fjord.
Yeah.
Archie Diggins has just arrived.
So oh, Archie Diggins.
Very late to the party. Hope we're all well. We are, Archie, but we're coming up to the very end.
To the very, very edge.
Of our time together this week. So, yeah, we've been busy preparing for our bingo event.
Yeah.
There is going to be merchandise on sale, isn't
yeah.
there?
Yeah, we're making merchandise.
Oh, I should have brought some up. Shall I go and get the badges?
Yes.
Right. Alan will have to keep talking and I'll be... A minute or two. We've got to get right downstairs.
So I think when we've done the odd quiz night at house, we toyed with making badges then. But because we had a really bad printer, we were doing sort of basic lettering badges. But we've been to the shops, went to a proper printers and got some printing done. And we've made a collection of little fridge magnets and badges of different images. For the weekend. So they're for you to buy if you would like them. So and we've actually bought ourselves a new printer this week. And it's a lot better than our old one. And here we are, always running up all these stairs. I bet you didn't bring any fridge magnets, did you?
No. But people have seen those, I've shared a picture of them. I can bring up a picture of the fridge magnets. Do you want me to bring that up first?
Yeah. So there's there we go.
Nana stays.
Divinity.
So the badges are going to be £2 each, aren't they?
The badges are, yeah.
£2 each or three for a fiver.
There's another one. Who's that pretty girl? Oh. I've even done a couple of our little AI pictures. Can you see that? Ooh, little Peggy's in it. Can you see it? I don't think they're looking at it.
Yeah, that's got a little Peggy at the bottom.
Look at that, looking blah, blah, blah. There we go. Can you see her? Can you see Sherry Stump? I don't think they're looking at her.
BG Bear says, ornamental buttons on a favourite coat.
Or earrings.
Earrings.
Croc drags there, look. What are we doing?
This one. Bingo wings. So you can get your bingo wings.
Got one that says, thank you, very glad. Oh, there's all sorts. You're going to be spot for choice.
We've got one that says camel toe. And then we've also got...
a moose knuckle.
Moose knuckle. So depending on what gender you identify as, you can either have a camel toe or a moose knuckle.
There's another... I don't know whether you've shown that one yet. Another AI one.
So yeah, lots of them. And... then the magnets, I can't, I'm not running down again for the magnets. I did have a picture of them.
So yes, we've bought a badge machine, as you must probably guess.
Do you know what, I can't show you the picture of the magnets because it's on my phone.
Well, if you go to our Facebook page, they're on there, aren't they?
Yeah. So we've got fridge magnets as well, and the fridge magnets are going to be £3.50, and the badges are £2 each or three for a fiver. So,
all handmade by us.
Yeah,
not for a factory.
Christopher Popjoy has just tuned in, watching you from Florida on way back to the UK.
Oh, Florida.
Squeam Queen says she would like us to make Isolation Creation Xmas ornaments. And Erica says she wants a T-shirt of Sherrie and Brandi. We've got one here, Erica, but it's it's a one-off. I don't know if you saw it last week.
That's lovely, that, isn't it? From the streets of Bangkok. It's a really good quality T-shirt, that. So yeah, that's what we've been doing this week. I've been making things for the show on Sunday. The costumes we've been sorting out.
Yeah, because I was let down. My Molly Morton... her whole outfit, we were let down.
Yeah, this is the problem with Vinted, is you'll buy something that you fall in love with, it's a one-off, and the doesn't post it.
Didn't send it.
Or can't be bothered with it, or can't be bothered to send it, or decides to take it off sale, or cancel the order. So it's a bit
and annoying
sometimes.
And then I bought a wig on Saturday night, a big wig, it was lovely, and I intended to pay for it on Sunday morning, which I said to the person, I'll pay on Sunday morning, because I bought it like Saturday night about 9 o'clock and we were watching telly. I thought, I'm not going all the way up to pay for it now. So I'll pay for it tomorrow morning. Got an email tomorrow morning from him saying, oh, I've sold it to someone else. Sorry, you didn't pay in time.
But the good thing is, the amount of money that you would have paid him, you've bought another two amazing wigs.
Two wigs, yeah, really 80s wigs.
So
we've got a drag queen who some of you will have heard of called Licorice Black, who follows us, and she's amazing, and everything she does is in black and white, and she's really fun, and she's gothy, and she creates loads of outfits for lots of the drag queens on Drag Race. I think Banksy, who's on this series of Drag Race, she creates a lot of her outfits. She's a fan of ours, we're a fan of hers, and I asked her who does her wigs, and she put me in touch with this great guy who does these 80s wigs that are very sort of Joan Collins.
Yeah.
So I'm getting some of that.
And I've got a wig being made for our show in February, which is being made at the moment.
Archie Diggins says, have we heard from Aldi yet about our sponsorship deal with the Biscoff?
They can't be arsed with us.
But we have got some people have sponsored us with prizes.
People have been so generous.
Yeah, we've got some lovely stuff. So if you win a full house, you can choose a prize. There's all sorts of stuff.
And if you're from Scarborough... there's some great vouchers to win.
Well, even if like Coral wins, then you know
she can use them while
get a voucher for when you're here. Yeah. So.
So, yeah, looking forward to it. Still sold out. It's going to be a good day.
Yeah, so it's it'll be nice and full.
And just to let you know that it's although the show starts at 4, doors open like well early.
Doors open at 3 o'clock.
Or even perhaps even earlier than that.
No.
No.
3 o'clock.
In that hour, you can have something to
eat. So get there at 3 o'clock because you can get some drinks. There might be the odd snack available. But you can get drinks. You can mix and mingle, have a laugh. There's some bespoke cocktails being made.
Yep.
There are some blood bag cocktails, limited editions, that come in a blood bag with the thing off them. The whole place has been done out all Halloween-y. We're going to have a fancy dress parade. We've got psychic mediums there to give you readings. Divinity and Molly Morton. Lots of games. It'll just be a really fun yeah. afternoon. And lots of people take photographs of it.
Oh, yeah, please, if you're coming, take photos.
And share them. Share them with us, especially, but share them. Louise Dudman has just popped in to say hello. And she says, oh, Halloween cockatees. There will be indeed, Louise. Louise is part of one of the teams who's been to... Louise has been to all of our quiz nights, hasn't she?
Yeah, she's...
And
truly amazing.
She sourced us some prizes for the fancy dress parade.
And her little gang that come are amazing. They're fun, aren't they?
Really fun.
We love them when they're there.
So, yeah, it's going to be a dead good atmosphere. So get there early to have a laugh. What are you chuckling at?
Me and Jason have a little thing that I'll be using on Sunday. Don't say it.
What is just written there that's highlighted?
Yeah, don't.
Oh, okay.
It's part of my... I've stolen that gag.
BG Bear says, was Licorice Black on Drag SOS? Yes, she was. Ribbons is apparently gutted to Miss Divinity. You'd love a reading from them. But we're going to see people there and have a laugh.
Yeah.
And it's going to be fun. And I've been playing around with... I was trying to choose glasses today, wasn't I, for Molly Morton?
And the glasses actually chosen were a gift to us from Jed Bear.
From BG.
BG Bear.
Yeah. So there were other ones I was going to wear, but you said I looked too sort of Dame Edna-y, didn't you?
Yeah, the glasses that BG Bear donated to us, gave us a gift, are amazing. So
we're excited about it. I'm dead nervous about it, but I always get nervous.
Yeah, I am.
But that's good.
But that's part of it, isn't it?
It is part of it. We're hoping someone comes as a Camp Jaws now, because
perhaps we should make Caroline come as Jaws now. Her version of Camp Jaws.
We can't wait, says Stuart Cahoon. Stuart and Lee, you're here Saturday night, are they?
Stuart, I think so, yeah.
So yeah, we see you Saturday night, hopefully. Archie Diggins says, was there a Wilco in Scarborough?
There was. Martin's just reminded me that on Sunday, we've got our pal Fleur, who works at the Stephen Joseph Theatre. And she was on Drag SOS.
Yeah, she was one of the stars of Drag SOS here in Scarborough. So yeah, she'll be there, and she's fierce and fabulous. Here she is, has popped in.
Oh,
here she is. I'm going to pop mine on for you, love.
Oh, here she is.
Here she is.
Oh, she's had a busy week. I've been following her a little. I saw a little bath photo. And then she was doing some filming.
Here she is, has been interviewing Paul Young, of all people.
And then she was out on the beach with Boswell.
Timmy Alexis, are you able to WhatsApp call me? Because I want to ask you about Paul Young.
What, wherever am I at?
Yeah. Give us a little video call. We'll bring... Here she is. We like Here She Is being a little special guest that pops in. Oh, here she is. She's been playing with Sue Pollard last week.
Oh, I can't wait to see that.
He'll be trying to get himself looking pretty. Because I've sent video calls.
He's always looking pretty. She's sitting pretty.
Nibbles and Bubbles says we don't talk about Wilcos anymore. And Lee Ludlow says, I remember when Wilco was called Wilkinson. And Archie Diggins says, I bought a fab witch's hat in Wilco's.
Oh, I love Wilco's. I used to go there as a student. We used to go there now, didn't we?
He says, I'll just get out of the bath, girls. Oh, love, if you're in the bath, don't you worry.
Don't get yourself all chapped, love.
I wanted to ask if you'd how he'd got on with Paul Young. Because Paul Young, of course, was, well, it was a crush of many people's. Was he a crush of yours at all?
Not really.
Who did you like? What's Craig what? McLaughlin, check 1-2.
Eh?
Who was your crush back then? Mike from Neighbours you liked, didn't you?
Yes.
But was there star that was...
First Scott.
A pop star? I can't think if I had a crush on a pop star. Your brother liked Nathan from Brother Beyond.
Well, he liked all Brother Beyond. I think he used to fantasize being, you know, being had by him.
Being roasted by Brother Beyond.
I don't think I had one. I don't think I had a crush. I don't remember any poster being on my wall of anyone particular.
Jill Barron's tuning in from the bus. Do you know, mine was Bruce Willis. I know he's not a pop star, but I loved Bruce Willis.
He was bloody hot in his day,
and he was a bit of a pop star. He did have an album.
He was bloody hot in his day, wasn't he? My mum had a thing for Shakin' Stevens.
I don't know if here she is going to ring in time.
Well, let her stay in the bath. Don't get out of the bath on a cold night like tonight.
Jason Darcy says the first Scott was hot, but sadly over the bridge now.
Oh, has he died? What was his name? He had a weird name, didn't he?
And Seven Networks says, Brother Beyond roasting to the harder I try it.
The harder I try.
Tushy Rushworth says his wife is Nathan's biggest fan. Nathan from Brother Beyond. Tushy Rushworth, when were you at Greatfield? Oh, here she is.
Oh, she's all...
Hello,
girls. Hello, love. Looking well.
We're sorry to get you out of your bath.
No, it was going cold. I'm like you. I just don't know when to get out.
Oh, I'd be so in there for hours. Do you top it up with your foot?
I've got a handle I can do with my hand. Or my butler comes in.
No, lovely. We want to know about Paul Young. How was it?
Well, here's a little thing for you. I thought, he's not getting me. But listening back to it, because I had to listen to it to know which then little bit of sting I'm going to send out what was funny. It was quite a nice little interview. I was a little bit low afterwards because I just thought, oh no, everyone gets old. Seemed like I was interviewing my dad.
Oh no.
He was a bit dithery and ooh. But actually, the interview's really good. And actually, what you were saying about being your childhood crush, he was mine as well.
Yeah. Now he...
So I was a bit nervous.
It's available to listen again, isn't it?
It is indeed. You can go, if you go to my website, they're all on there. www.hereshears.co.uk.
I don't think we need the W's nowadays.
Do we not?
I think you could just say hereshears.co.uk.
Oh.
Do you know what? You're very down with the kids. You know all the things, don't you?
Now, did you ask him?
She's here, Alan, isn't it?
She's a tech wizard.
Did you ask him about...
He keeps us modern.
Did you ask him about Gino De Campo?
Do you know what? It was out there, but I didn't get round to it because the time just went.
Oh.
I did ask him about Splash.
Oh, did you?
Can you remember?
Now
he was in Splash.
He was on Splash with Penny Mordaunt, wasn't he?
I don't know, but I just said, why did you do that? Did they offer you a lot of money? What about literally going on in just swimming trunks and diving?
Now, Timmy, I seem to remember, because he was a bit of a crush of mine, that Paul Young didn't opt for a Speedo.
He just said that.
No, he was in like a boxer one, wasn't he? Yeah. I did ask about that, whether they bought their own.
Bermuda shorts.
Has he done the jungle?
Can you remember? No, he hasn't done the jungle, but can you remember Gemma Collins? Almost had a ball gown on, didn't she?
Yeah. Did Paul Young do Back to Reality with Dollar? No.
Pop Goes the Band, wasn't it?
Oh, was it?
Yeah.
Is that with Sonia?
No, he didn't do it. That was Dollar, Bucks Fizz, when they all have the facelifts and things.
No, with Sonia, where Sonia comes back and Dollar have a beef.
Oh, that's on your show, isn't it?
One in the USA.
Oh, yeah.
Above that.
How was Dame Sue Pollard?
But first of all, what about also, we forget about Paul Young, he did the Band-Aid song.
He did?
Oh, he did do the Band-Aid.
And did you know that he took over from, what's his name, Who's Rocket? Not Rocket Man, the other one with the different coloured eyes.
David Bowie.
David Bowie was going to do his part. So he was all a bit nervous, and then he went in because he'd only had the one album, he was saying.
Oh.
But he's very... I loved him. I think that might be a posh private school crush thing, because Alan didn't love him, did you, Alan?
No, I didn't. I'm thinking about all the men I had a crush on, the pop stars. I don't think there were any.
Really? Are you properly gay?
Yeah. I can't remember any. I can't remember. If I think about it, I'll come up with some, but it'll be really odd, I think.
Nick Haywood. Nick Haywood was gorgeous.
Nick Haywood.
Yeah,
I, you know, I liked a bit of, you know, the one who's put a bit of weight on. I think he sang Spandau Ballet. Hadley.
Oh, not Tony Hadley.
Mm. But even more so since he's piled on the pounds.
No, not for me. Simon Le Bon's piled on the pounds. Actually, have you seen Jamiroquai as well?
No.
I sent you it, didn't I? They've all got these pot bellies now.
Oh.
Now, before we let you go, how was Dame Sue Pollard?
Dame Sue Pollard was absolutely amazing. Now, yeah. You know what clip comedy clip I showed her?
Mm.
Which one?
I went for the holiday park, the seaside thing.
Oh yeah, did she like it?
She got it.
Went for fabulous!
Because she's so professional, but she really went for it. It was really good. It's going to be a really nice episode, and she got a bit touched. And I don't mean by me, but when she was talking about the antibiotic high, it's a very nice little moment.
When will we expect to see it on our screens?
Well, I've got to film either tomorrow or Friday my bits and pieces. I know that sounds rude, but I've got to do that. And then I'll place that all together. But I'm not putting pressure on myself. I want it to be really good. So I'm going to really go through it with a fine-tooth comb before I release it. And then I've got the lovely... Do you know Ben Richards?
I know the name.
He was in Footballers' Wives. He was in The Bill. He's currently playing the Duke in Moulin Rouge at the minute. If you look him up, he's a very handsome fella. So he's my next guest. So I'm going to get this done and then him come on.
Oh, very nice. All right, lovely.
Listen, good luck with all your new adventures. It's all going well, isn't it?
Oh, yeah. This weekend we've got a show. It's on Sunday.
How long would it take me to come to Scarborough? How long does it take?
King's Cross to York. But on train. Do you travel by train?
Yeah. Yes. I have security. I have an invitation to go on the underground cab.
So you'd get a train from King's Cross to York, about 2 hours, and then you have to change, and it's 50 minutes to Scarborough.
How long is that in total then? Nearly three hours?
Nearly 3 hours, and then with the change, it could be like three and a half.
With the change. Yeah, and that doesn't include any bloody delays.
All right, lovely.
Nice to see you,
Eric.
Girls.
All right, loves. Bye.
Bye.
Oh, he's got the bath just for us.
Oh, bless him.
Oh.
All right, loves. Right. Let's say goodnight to these people. It's nearly 10 o'clock. So we'll see a lot of you on Saturday night.
Mm-hmm.
We'll see even more of you on Sunday. And then the rest of you, we will see...
On Wednesday.
Next Wednesday. I'm up. I'm teaching tomorrow.
Who are you? What time?
Diversity. Diversity what and inclusion. 11:30, I've got to be on.
Is that on? Switched on?
I've got to be, switched on. Live. All right, loves. What should we end with today? Should we end with the Brookside cast?
Oh.
We enjoy the Brookside cast.
Yes. Yeah. Julie Brogan.
All right, loves. See those of you who we're seeing on Sunday and Saturday. And
the rest of you, my darlings, next week.
Bye, everyone.
Lots of love.
Bye. Bye.
And here with their own song, let them know, the cast of Brookside with special guest Ruby Turner.
Do you know? Do you care? Are you really aware?
You think the world is kinda hard, it's kinda harder down here. Have you heard, have you seen the kind of loving they need?
It isn't much, just enough to let them know we believe.
The sunny walks, the rainy days, the seaside ice creams in bay.
Tender words and singing birds, or just a new lamb of play.
Funny talks and crazy ways, playing marbles all day. Paper planes and daisy chains, come together now and let them know that it's your world. Let them know that it's your.
Do you know, do you care, life can be so unfair. You think the road is kind of tough, kind of tougher down here. Have you heard, have you seen the kind of children in need, but simply just a part of us, but let them know we believe.
Sharing joy and ease and pain, you know it never goes without saying. It isn't much to get in touch, could be a new life you're making.
Spare a thought.